यूरोपियन पार्लियामेंट ने पाकिस्तान के खिलाफ करारदाद भारी अक्सरियत से मंजूर कर ली है। करारदाद में पाकिस्तान के लिए GSP प्लस पर नजरसानी करने और अकलियतों से मुतालिक इम्तियाजी कानून के खात्मे का मुतालबा किया गया है।
पाकिस्तान इज फेसिंग अ पोटेंशियल थ्रेट टू इट्स EU एक्सपोर्ट्स फॉलोइंग द यूरोपियन पार्लियामेंट्स डिसीजन ऑफ 30 अप्रैल 2021 टू अडॉप्ट अ रेजोल्यूशन कॉलिंग फॉर अ रिव्यू ऑफ द कंट्रीज GSP प्लस स्टेटस। The resolution cites serious concerns over the continued and systematic enforcement of blasphemy laws in the country, which the resolution states makes it dangerous for religious minorities to express themselves freely and has cast a pall of fear over Pakistani society. Pakistan's GSP Plus status is in jeopardy. But what exactly is GSP Plus? And why does it matter? And what does France have to do with it? Sorch explains GSP Plus. In 1971, the European Union introduced its Generalized Scheme of Preferences, or GSP, an arrangement which reduces or removes tariffs and quotas on products coming into the EU from developing countries. A tariff is a tax put on imported products. Generally, countries that want to export their products into the EU single market have to pay the required tariff for each product. A quota, on the other hand, is a limit on the number of products of one type a country can export into the EU single market. Under the GSP mechanism, the EU adapts its tariffs and quotas to products coming from certain developing countries, making it easier for these countries to participate in international trade. The modern GSP regime encompasses three tiers of tariff preferences and commitments based on a beneficiary country's level of development. These tiers are the General GSP, the Everything But Arms Arrangement, and GSP Plus. The rules that define each GSP tier are laid down under an EU regulation which is valid until 2023. The three types of GSP tiers have two common objectives: reducing poverty and promoting good governance. Under the General GSP tier, countries classified as lower or lower to middle income by the World Bank receive duty reductions on a little over 66% of all products accepted for import into the EU. Under the Everything But Arms Arrangement, countries identified as least developed by the UN receive duty-free and quota-free access for all imports, except arms and ammunition. GSP Plus, which was introduced in 2014, is a special incentive arrangement specifically designed to support long-term sustainable growth in target countries. Beneficiaries are entitled to zero duties on 66% of all products accepted for import into the EU. But the tariff preferences do not come without conditions. The GSP scheme, and GSP Plus in particular, is part of a wider effort by the EU to promote and protect human rights in non-EU countries through preferential trade deals. So, to acquire and maintain GSP Plus status, countries are required to ratify and implement 27 different international conventions on human rights, labor, governance, and other sustainable development issues. There are currently 8 countries with GSP Plus status, including Pakistan. The EU keeps a close watch on whether each GSP Plus country is complying with implementation requirements. UN monitoring bodies prepare reports that are then used to generate a scorecard for each GSP Plus country. The scorecard highlights progress made by the country, as well as any shortcomings that need to be addressed to effectively implement the 27 conventions. The EU and GSP Plus countries engage in ongoing dialogue over any concerns raised by the scorecard. Drawing from the monitoring process, the EU Commission provides a report to the European Parliament and the Council of the European Union every 2 years. The European Council and Parliament then review each GSP Plus country. If the review finds that a country is failing to comply with its ratification, implementation, or monitoring commitments, GSP Plus status can be temporarily withdrawn. Despite its relative infancy, GSP Plus has become incredibly important for Pakistan's economy. Of all the countries that currently have GSP Plus status, Pakistan is the leading beneficiary. According to the EU's 2018 to 2019 biannual report on the scheme, almost 3/4 of all European imports from the GSP Plus program come from Pakistan. Under the GSP Plus arrangement, More than 76% of Pakistan's exports to the EU, including textiles and clothing, are duty and quota free. As of 2019, this represented almost 20% of Pakistan's exports globally. From 2010 to 2020, Pakistan's exports to the EU almost doubled, from 3.1 billion euros to 5.5 billion euros. The growth of exports was particularly fast following the award of GSP Plus to Pakistan in January 2014, with a 30% increase between 2014 and 2016. The growth of Pakistan's exports to the EU has since slowed down, but the country continues to enjoy a trade surplus with the EU. As we now know, the GSP Plus scheme links human rights obligations to trade incentives, meaning that as a GSP Plus beneficiary, Pakistan's economic future is closely tied to its human rights record. In February 2020, the European Commission published a report assessing Pakistan's compliance with GSP Plus requirements thus far. The report states that Pakistan is making progress on adopting laws on the protection of women and children rights, elimination of honor killings, protection of transgender persons, protection of the environment, and good governance. It notes in particular the enactment of the Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Act in 2018 and the passage by the Senate of the Child Marriage Restraint Bill in 2019, as well as the launch of a national child labor survey. But the document also notes a number of concerns, stating that the trend is negative when it comes to space for civil society and voices of dissent, with a high level of impunity for perpetrators of crimes against journalists. A significant concern highlighted in the document is the status of Pakistan's National Commission for Human Rights, the NCHR, which the government of Pakistan created precisely to meet its obligations under the GSP Plus scheme. The tenure of the organization's last commissioners expired in May 2019, and new commissioners are yet to be appointed to leadership positions, which is hampering the institution's functioning. In March 2021, the Islamabad High Court ordered the ruling PTI party to issue an advertisement for leadership roles in the commission, after activists and former NCHR workers accused Prime Minister Imran Khan's government of delaying appointments to avoid facing accountability for human rights violations, particularly those allegedly committed by the military. In addition to concerns, the report highlights a number of priority areas for action going forward, including freedom of expression, prevention of torture, forced, bonded, and child labor, freedom of association, anti-corruption, and the scope of the death penalty. But the report contains no indication that Pakistan's GSP Plus status is at risk. This must mean that developments after February 2020, when the report was released, prompted the recent EU resolution. The resolution, which was passed with overwhelming support, does note that the year 2020 saw an alarming increase in accusations of blasphemy online and offline in Pakistan. It further alleges that Pakistan's blasphemy laws incite harassment, violence, and murder against those being accused, and are easily manipulated by people making false accusations to serve personal interests. In particular, the resolution notes the cases of Shagufta Kausar and Shafqat Emmanuel, who were sentenced to death on blasphemy charges in 2014, based on what the resolution describes as deeply flawed evidence. Interestingly, on June 3, 2021, just 1 month after the EU resolution was adopted, the Lahore High Court acquitted Kausar and Emmanuel and set aside their death sentences. Let's be clear. Concerns about Pakistan's blasphemy laws are valid. For years, these laws have been used to target members of minority communities and settle personal vendettas. In September 2020, the Human Rights Commission of Pakistan issued a press release expressing grave concern at the recent surge in blasphemy cases being registered against sectarian and religious minorities, and called on the state to uphold all citizens' right to freedom of religion or belief. It's also clear, however, that the EU's desire to re-evaluate Pakistan's GSP Plus status is tied not only to concerns over the country's blasphemy laws, but also to recent political developments, most notably the recent anti-French protests in the country over France's perceived animosity towards Islam. The resolution states that the European Parliament is deeply concerned by the anti-French sentiment in Pakistan and considers violent demonstrations and attacks against France unacceptable. Just days before the resolution was adopted, the government of Pakistan banned the Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan under anti-terrorism laws. The group turned violent while demanding the expulsion of the French ambassador in protest of President Emmanuel Macron's support for the publication of cartoons depicting the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, amongst other French state actions viewed as being Islamophobic. Against this backdrop, the EU resolution is viewed by some within Pakistan as an overreaction to criticisms of the French government's alleged Islamophobia and a tactic of coercion in future dialogue with the EU. Human Rights Minister Shirin Mazari described the EU Parliament's resolution as an anti-Pakistan resolution and stressed the importance of dialogue as opposed to extreme public positioning. She further suggested that a more sinister element was at play, noting that one of the co-sponsors of the resolution was a member of a political party described by the Swedish Prime Minister as neo-fascist with racist roots, apparently referring to Swedish MEP Charlie Wymers. Meanwhile, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs said in a statement that the resolution reflects a lack of understanding in the context of blasphemy laws and associated religious sensitivities in Pakistan and the wider Muslim world. While the political motivations behind the EU resolution should be considered, the Pakistan government's reaction to the TLP protests only made matters worse. In a series of tweets, Prime Minister Imran Khan said the group was banned not for its political agenda, but only because it challenged the writ of the state by holding protests. So the group was basically banned for its tactics rather than its aims. In fact, the Prime Minister claimed to embrace the same political goals as the TLP, stating that Western governments that have outlawed negative comments on the Holocaust should use the same standards to penalize those spreading their message of hate against Muslims by abusing the Prophet, peace be upon him. Islamophobia is a serious problem, and there is no doubt that anti-Muslim sentiment has been on the rise in Europe for at least the last two decades. But Prime Minister Imran Khan's analogy between blasphemy laws and Holocaust denial laws doesn't take into account that Holocaust denial laws exist to prevent hate speech against insecure minority communities. On the other hand, Pakistan's blasphemy laws are frequently used by members of the majority population to target insecure minorities. Accusing people of blasphemy in Pakistan does nothing to reduce Islamophobia in the rest of the world. If anything, actions like those of the TLP contribute to Islamophobia, just as the inflammatory rhetoric of right-wing parties in Europe contributes to anti-Western feeling in Pakistan. Ultimately, in hopes of ending the TLP protests, the government of Pakistan agreed to put a resolution before the National Assembly on whether to expel the French ambassador. This is somewhat extraordinary, considering not only Pakistan's trade ties with the EU, but also that France, a founding member of the EU, has been a major supplier of military hardware to Pakistan for over 50 years. No decision about whether to expel the French ambassador has been made yet. And now, with the EU Parliament's resolution looming, the case to expel the ambassador is likely dead in the water. Though, of course, like with our cricket team, we can't rule anything out. Similarly, it remains to be seen whether Pakistan's GSP Plus status will be withdrawn. According to recent reports, Prime Minister Imran Khan chaired a meeting comprising senior ministers of his cabinet to review the EU resolution. During the meeting, the Prime Minister is said to have stressed that the government would not compromise on the laws pertaining to the finality of the prophethood. But it's a tricky situation for the government of Pakistan. Participants at the meeting were told the country could suffer an annual loss of $3 billion if its GSP Plus status is revoked. It's clear that Pakistan needs to grow its exports in order to bolster its economy. The last thing the country needs is fewer exports. And while many living in post-colonial countries may take issue with the Western world's often selective application of human rights standards, Pakistan agreed to comply with certain requirements when it acquired GSP Plus status. Now, with the country's human rights record under international scrutiny, it must take steps to live up to its obligations under international human rights conventions. And let's not forget, the human rights of all Pakistanis should be upheld, not just to comply with external commitments, but because all human beings deserve to be treated with equal dignity.